Hi, it's Todd of Todd's Workshop and Todd Cutler here, and I'm back with my night vision camera protective equipment. Polycarbonate visor, steel reenactment helmet for mounting my GoPros in, so hopefully I'll stop killing them. But the reason I'm back is I've seen something really interesting here and I've just got to show you. So have a look at the inside. That's our arrow going through there, 18 centimeters through the front. Then here we've got the mount for the camera. It bounced off that, there's a big gouge in the side of it. And then it created that little pimple right in the back there. So it bounced off the mount, whacked into the back, and it still did that. Now in the film, and you can see here, it's striking at maybe 40, 45 degrees. It really surprised me that it went through so cleanly and easily. And I dismissed that just by saying, oh, well, it must be where the armourer had just, you know, formed it and polished it away. And actually, it was really thin. I looked at this again now, and I noticed these things, the dent and the gouge. And I thought, well, that is interesting. I wonder how thin it was, because it must have been pretty rubbishy. So I drilled a little test hole, right? Just next to the arrow, right next to it. 1.8 millimeters deep, my depth gauge gives me on that. So that arrow went through 1.8 mm of mild, so 16th of an inch, just over, bounced off something and dented the back. Now, continuously, I am surprised by what these bows can do, but my goodness, that amazes me. Absolutely stuns me. And don't forget, yes, it is the lockdown longbow. It is a crossbow, but it shoots these medieval weight arrows at the same speed that Joe Gibbs' 160-pound Mary Rose replica shoots them at. So it's not that I'm cheating in that sense. I'm just cheating because I'm a weed. I'm no Joe Gibbs. But it has done this. It is extraordinary. So I think what we can do is use that as an assessment point, again, which is what all these films are. It's an assessment point to say that longbow arrows can go through pretty low grade armour, or even perhaps in this case medium grade armour. You know, that's not 1.8 mil, it's not shoddy. So that is an extraordinary result. But that brings me on to the next point, which is a few years ago we did, a whole bunch of us, including Joe shooting, did medieval Mythbusting arrows versus armour, where we shot a 2.5 mil Cherbourg style breastplate in carbon steel. We're coming back. Four more films are planned for this year. Hopefully we're going to do it. Fingers crossed. It's all been a bit difficult, rather obviously. But we're going to be doing it with real materials. So real medieval style steel, real medieval style arrowheads made out of the right material. And Joe is about as medieval style as you can get as a shooter. So we're coming back. It's going to be expensive. We're going to be fundraising it. So that's why we're preempting it now. Just letting you know it's coming. But it will be here and it will be special. Anyway, thank you very much. Yeah.